Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, and today we will be painting a little galaxy with watercolors. It's going to be a narrated step-by-step tutorial. I'm going to go through all the materials I will be using throughout this video, and if you want, there's a full list in the description below the video as well. To start, I take my custom watercolors, but any watercolor palette will do. And in my case, I will be using this brush, but feel free to use a normal one like this. There is absolutely no difference. The only difference is I have my water here with this one, so I don't have to keep an extra cup or a water jar. And I'm painting on my bed right now, so that's just going to end up in a huge mess. So I just unscrew this and I screw on the actual brush. Now feel free to use a normal one, just dip it in your jar and put a little water drop into your colors. For this painting I plan on using mostly greens and some blues. You can use whatever colors you want, and I will be using a color called indigo, and it's basically a very deep, dark, intense blue color. And just drop some water into each of the colors that I plan to use, and what this does is it moisturizes them, so they're very creamy when we go in painting with them. They give you very nice, strong colors. Now set this aside and I take some clear normal office tape, just the most plain tape you can find. What I do is I'm going to roughly measure how much I need, and we are going to tape down this painting, because if we don't do this, when we add the water, it's going to go all wavy like this, so it's going to give us some problems. And we take the piece and wrap it around your skin or your shirt, whatever you prefer. It doesn't matter really, but by doing so, I don't know if you can see, it makes it less sticky, so it will not tear up your page once you actually finish your painting. And now I'm just going to repeat the same exact process for all three remaining sides. For the last side, because my sketchbook is getting bulky, I'm going to cut a bit longer than I need, about this much. Again, this, the same exact process, I'm just wrapping it around my wrist, around my hand, and sort of try to get it less sticky. Now I put this to the edge, and also I tape it down to the very back of my sketchbook. This way it lays flat. This side doesn't go up, we don't get any crazy waves. And by the way, this is 200 grams watercolor paper. It's the worst quality you can find, basically. And by now, our paints, these are Van Gogh watercolors, are nice and creamy. So I'm going to add some random drops of water to my page and just carry them around. This way we are wetting the paper sheet, and we do this so once we lay down the colors, they will flow quite nicely and mix on their own, which is very helpful and gives very pretty effects. Okay, it has to be a bit shiny when you look on it. And now basically you put whatever colors you want. I would like to go for a turquoise color galaxy, So I take some green right here. This is phthalo green, some water to it, and I mix it with some blue, and this is phthalo blue, so it's going to give me a very nice turquoisey color. You can use orange, you can use red, you can use purple, whatever colors you like. And now we are going to drop it randomly, I repeat, randomly onto the paper, and it's going to give us very nice effects. And if it doesn't really flow as much, like in my case, just add a little bit more water, which will help. And again, just random places, really. I'm not trying to go with a pattern or anything, because in my opinion, when you are painting galaxies, randomness is really the key, because you are letting it do whatever it wants, sort of like what nature does. So yeah, just randomly. Now, I have toilet paper. I'm not ashamed of that. And I'm just going to add little highlights into areas that, in my opinion, got too big, there is too much color. Okay, something like that. Now, I think I'll add a bit more green. This is phthalo green. And if it doesn't flow, just add a little extra drop of water. Like so. I sort of repeat where I already went, and this way it sort of deepens the color, if that makes any sense. Like you can see here, we have blue going out, but the center remained green, so it's a very nice effect. Just some of the areas. And then I go with indigo, which is basically a very deep, intense blue color. It almost looks like black, but once you dilute it with water, you can see it sort of blue, violet, gray tones. And again, randomness is key, but I try making it darkest around the corners of my painting. So I'm going really random and light towards the center. And by the way, this indigo color is by Winsor and Newton Cotman, and it's from a tube. I just squeezed it in and I let it dry. And I don't mind having some of my dark color going with my light colors. I think that just gives more depth to it and makes it more interesting. So, a little bit more around here. If you make an area too dark, or if you add too much color, or whatever your reason is, just get some toilet paper, tissue, kitchen paper, and dab it slightly, push it slightly on your paper, and you get back your white, the whiteness of the paper. I'm actually very satisfied with this right now. I might add a little bit, I don't know, extra. Just play around with adding a bit extra color and lifting it up, pushing paper, like tissue paper, onto your painting. Is called lifting up, by the way. Now, when we tilt this, if you get any excess water right here, like me, just tap slightly. And the reason we do this is, if we just skip this step, it's going to dry with very weird, harsh edges, and it's just going to look strange. Now I'm going to clean up my brush. If you have a normal one, just go like Bob Ross, but in your water cup. If you have a brush like this, just squeeze and rub until it comes off clean. Now we let this to air dry, but you can also use a hair dryer or something called a heat gun, but I don't really recommend that because in my opinion the colors will dry very flat if you use that. I just prefer to leave it to air dry. In the meanwhile, you can make some tea, you can grab a snack, and we'll be right back. When your paint is completely dry, it's going to look almost matte. It's not going to be shiny anymore, the painted part. So this is the moment when we add the stars. And there are various ways you can do this. One is by using either white acrylic paint or white gouache diluted with some water. You can use a white pen. This is Posca. It's again acrylic, so you can draw the individual stars, which is a bit of a task. Or you can stay true to the watercolor medium and use white watercolors. This is the only white I have. They also sell it in half pans like this. It comes in tubes, but I just don't have that right now, so I'm going to use this white watercolor cake. I have some water right in the cake. These round ones are called cakes, by the way, and the rectangular ones are called pans or half pans. Now I'm going to take a stiff, again, you need a stiff brush for this. So like an acrylic brush would do perfect, but don't use a very soft watercolor brush. You can use a toothbrush, that one works as well. I'm just using the tip of this eraser pencil. And I load it with some paint watercolors. Now the size and amount of stars you get really depends on the distance you keep the brush and also the force with which you flick it. If you're using acrylics or gouache, it's the same exact technique. You dilute it with water, like we added water right here, and you load the brush. It's the same exact thing. And you can see if I make very small flicks, I get very small stars. If I make very large ones, then I get large stars. So you can add as many or as few as you want. That's completely up to you. Again, if you don't like some of your stars, just use a little tissue or toilet paper, kitchen paper, whatever you have. And I'm going to add some more. Mistakes like this happen, but it's not a problem. Just try to control your flicks. Okay, I think I'm happy with this right now. Just cleaning up any weird shape stars that I have. I'm going to slightly clean the tape so I don't get watercolors on my hand. And now I'm going to untape this. I find it's best to peel slowly and at a degree, at an angle, excuse me. So, very slowly, no hurry. And if you get little tears like this, it's normal. Just take the other side and try to get it clean there. And sometimes it doesn't happen. If you happen to have a white pen, completely optional, you can add some bigger and brighter stars, like these classic ones, like one here and one here, so it pops up a bit better, you know, and maybe another one right here. And lastly, we sign. Thank you all for watching, and we'll see each other in the next video.